New this morning, there was a lot new this morning, but listen to this. A scathing report in the Wall Street Journal says that President Trump's former personal lawyer and fixer, Michael Cohen, hired a firm to rig online polls to help then-candidate. CNN Now exclusively has this statement confirming that story from Michael Cohen himself. It says the following: what I did was at the direction of and for the sole benefit of Donald J. Trump. I truly regret my blind loyalty to a man who doesn't deserve it, implicating the president in this payment.
And again, that coming from Michael Cohen exclusively to CNN this morning. So what is this Wall Street Journal story about? Well, Cohen allegedly gave the owner of a pretty small tech company thousands of dollars in cash in a Walmart bag when he came to Trump Tower as payment for writing online scripts to help Trump score better in polls, rigging online polls to the benefit of the president. With us now is MJ Lee, CNN national political correspondent. Anything here illegal?
Yeah, just to add to the growing list of bizarre Michael Cohen headlines, let me just walk you through the Wall Street Journal story. It is reporting that in 2015, a man named John Gouger, he runs a tech company, as you said, Poppy, went to Trump Tower to collect $50,000 for work that he did for Michael Cohen to try to rig online polls for then-candidate Donald Trump, who was running for president, so that he could have better poll numbers. Now, we don't know if that effort was successful, but this was the work that he says he performed for Michael Cohen on Donald Trump's behalf. Now, the story says that Michael Cohen handed over to John Gouger, this guy, a Walmart bag full of around $12,000 in cash. Now, Cohen, to the Wall Street Journal, denies that piece of the reporting, says that all monies paid to Mr. Gouger were by check. So the cash bag part of this, Michael Cohen is denying. Now, Gouger goes on to claim in the Wall Street Journal that he did not get paid in full, that what was promised to him was the $50,000. But what the Journal is also reporting, and this is significant, is that in 2017, even though Michael Cohen did not pay this full amount to this guy who was trying to rig the online polls for Donald Trump, that Cohen still asked Donald Trump for the full payment of $50,000 and that he was paid this money. So again, just to emphasize, the headline from this story is that Michael Cohen paid this guy around $12,000 to $13,000, according to this person. And then 2 years later, he asked Donald Trump for more money than what he allegedly paid out of his pocket. And Poppy, according to that statement that you just read from Michael Cohen that we just got, all of this comes back to loyalty. Michael Cohen's defense now for a while has been that all of these things that he did that were, frankly, really sketchy, he did out of blind loyalty to Donald Trump. This is obviously going to be a huge, huge narrative that we see when Michael Cohen testifies in Congress next month.
Yeah, set for that testimony, MJ, as you know, set for February 7th. And you're learning some new details about the concerns he has about testifying before Congress. What are they?
That's right. I mean, we are learning that Michael Cohen is basically concerned about his family. This is obviously going to be a huge day on Capitol Hill. We are all going to be covering this very, very closely. And Michael Cohen's concern right now remains his family and what all of this would do to them. And this is not a new concern that we are learning about. Even when he was under investigation, as Michael Cohen was waiting for months to get his sentencing finally from the judge here in New York, he was afraid of the toll that all of this was taking on his family. And keep in mind, too, his concern for his family was actually the reason that he made some of his legal decisions that he made as he was waiting for his sentencing. Even before he was able to get a full cooperation with prosecutors, he decided he's going to get the sentencing on the day that was originally determined because his strategy was, I want to put this behind me as quickly as possible so that I can move on and so that my family can move on.
MJ Lee, thanks very much.
Paul Callen is back with us. Just the legal question here, right? I mean, did he admit to a crime here by confirming that, yes, I did this, but it was at the sole benefit of and direction of the president?
He quite possibly did. There is a federal crime called wire fraud or mail fraud, where if you use federal mails or telephones or the internet to communicate over wires and to defraud somebody, that's a federal crime.
So this would be, in essence, defrauding the American people.
Yes.
But by the president as well? I mean, if Cohen's saying the president directed him.
Oh,
yes, he does. So that would pull the president into it. But here's the problem with the theory actually being used by prosecutors. You'd probably wipe out half the Congress because everybody exaggerates what they're doing in the polls, or they discredit a poll.
Pay someone off to skew the polls?
I don't know. Prosecutors will look at this and say, will every opponent of another candidate claim that he's using rigged polls? I think you could make a criminal case out of it, but I think it would be a tough one. The other problem here that I see with Michael Cohen is that obviously he only paid the guy that he hired to rig the poll $13,000 or $12,000, but he billed the president $50,000. So Trump's going to come in and say, I'm the victim of Michael Cohen. He defrauded me as well as maybe the public.
And this,
so,
you know, the Wall Street Journal says that, look, the Trump org didn't ask what the money was for. And Cohen did the $50,000, and Cohen.
There's a lot more details we need on this Michael Cohen story to see how it plays out.
Well, Cohen's saying explicitly to CNN he did this at the direction of the president.
Yes.
Significant.
Okay, it's been a tough day for Mr. Trump today.
It's 9:23 in the morning. Right. Mm-hmm. Thanks very much, Paul.